नमस्कार केर वलिए चर्चा मुलपेरिया अणकट वी मुलपेरिया डाम उ डाम सुरक्षा बिल राज्यसभा चर्चा केर इड़ वलद सभलूमे रूक्ष विमर्शन इवर्के उयर जन चलव दिल्ली सुखवास अद राज्य पणंको नक्षत्र हॉटल कहियानो इवर सोशल मीडिया चोदिक मुलपेरिया आशंक राज्यसभा सवर्णवसर तेर एम पी नष्टपड़ी राज्यसभा मुलपेरिया विषय चर्चा उन्नर वादू बीजेपी एम पी आय अलफोस कणंदारू തമിഴ്നാട്ടിലെ ഡിഎംകെ സർക്കാരിനെയും സ്റ്റാലിനെയും പിണക്കാതെ തന്നെ സിപിഎം എംപിമാർ നിലപാടെടുത്തപ്പോൾ തമിഴ്നാട്ടിലെ എംപിമാർ ആവട്ടെ കേരളത്തെ നിർത്തിപ്പോരിച്ചും അപമാനിച്ചും രാജ്യസഭയിൽ വലിയ വാദങ്ങൾ ഉന്നയിച്ചു ഇതിനെ ഒന്ന് പ്രതിരോധിക്കാൻ പോലും കേരളത്തിലെ ഇടതുവലത് എംപിമാർ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നില്ല കോൺഗ്രസ് നേതാക്കളായ രാജ്യസഭാ എംപിമാരായ എകെ ആന്റണിയും കെസി വേണുഗോപാലും ഇക്കാര്യങ്ങൾ അറിഞ്ഞിട്ടുമില്ല डाम सुरक्षा बिल राज्यसभा वह अन्वेष एके आंटणिया ऑफिस इक्यम अल मेसी वेणुगोपाल चर्ची पक अलफोस कणंदान पुमे बिल चर्चा आगे पीपीएम अंगा वि शिवदासन मुलपेरिया वाकुपोल अद्हम उच्चीएमके नेता नवनीत कृष्णन एम डी एम के वैको ഡിഎംകെയുടെ ഇളങ്കോവനും ഡാം സുരക്ഷാ ബില്ലിൽമേൽ നടന്ന ചർച്ചയിൽ മുല്ലപ്പെരിയാർ വിഷയത്തിൽ തമിഴ്നാടിനു വേണ്ടി പ്രതിരോധം തീർത്തപ്പോൾ കേരളത്തിനു വേണ്ടി ആകെ പ്രതിരോധം തീർത്തത് ബിജെപി നേതാവ് അൽഫോൺസ് കണ്ണന്താനം മാത്രമായിരുന്നു മുല്ലപ്പെരിയാറിന് എന്തെങ്കിലും സംഭവിച്ചാൽ അഞ്ചു ജില്ലകൾ ഒലിച്ചുപോകുമെന്ന് കണ്ണന്താനം പറഞ്ഞു ലോകത്തിലെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ ദുരന്തമായി ഇത് മാറും കേന്ദ്ര സർക്കാരും സംസ്ഥാനങ്ങളും ഒരുമിച്ച് പ്രശ്നപരിഹാരത്തിന് പ്രയത്നിക്കണമെന്ന് കണ്ണന്താനം ആവശ്യപ്പെട്ടു ഒടുവിൽ കണ്ണന്താനം ഉയർത്തിയ വാദങ്ങൾ സഭ അംഗീകരിച്ച് ഡാം സുരക്ഷാ ബിൽ രാജ്യസഭയിൽ പാസായി കണ്ണന്താനത്തിന്റെ തീപൊരി പ്രസംഗത്തിലേക്ക്
I would like to speak about the case of Mullapariya dam sir this dam is situated in Kerala in 1886 the Maharaja of Travancore he executed a lease deed with the secretary of state of the British empire leasing out 8000 acres of land in Kerala to Tamil Nadu to build a dam and all the water from this dam would go to Tamil Nadu fair enough and the amount of money lease deed that was fixed was 40000 rupees I have no complaint we become independent in 56 Kerala becomes a state in 1970 Kerala voluntarily signed a supplementary lease agreement saying Tamil Nadu will have not only the water you can also produce electricity and that power is given to you and the total lease deed annually for this entire 8000 acres of land is only 2,50,000 rupees does it matter in fact I live in two lodhi estate and Jorbagh is next door one square meter of land in Jorbagh is going at 15 lakhs per square meter and 8000 acres of land in Kerala is going at annual rental of 2,50,000. Does it matter, sir? According to me, I will appeal to the Kerala Chief Minister to make it free. Why should we collect this amount? Water is a national source. It belongs to the people of India. If there is plenty of rain in Kerala, which God has given, nature has given, in fact, we have excess rain in Kerala. That water should be shared with the neighboring state of Tamil Nadu free. And therefore, please, John, Mr. John Buttas, who has been trying to speak here, please.
Please persuade
your chief minister to execute a supplementary agreement by which the water will go free. Now, sir, Kerala depends on Tamil Nadu for everything. Sir, for our existence, we depend on Tamil Nadu. All the food that is eaten in Kerala, sir, is either produced in Kerala or comes to Tamil Nadu. All the vegetables that is consumed in Kerala, sir, is produced in Tamil Nadu. Sir, and our own language, Malayalam, it is only about a few hundred years old. It is evolved from Tamil. And therefore, sir, we are completely obliged to Tamil Nadu for our culture, for our existence. And again, in a lighter sense, if liquor doesn't come through Tamil Nadu, Kerala will go crazy. because we have the largest consumption of liquor in Kerala, and even for liquor we cannot depend on Tamil Nadu. Sir, I am deeply obliged on behalf of the people of Kerala. Sir, I would like to place on record my deep appreciation to Tamil Nadu. Sir Shivaji, we have lost in the court. Supreme Court has said sorry. You don't need a new dam, even though dam was commissioned, sir, in 1895, sir. 126-year-old dam, which is made of what? No concrete. It's a Surki dam, sir. What is Surki? Lime, egg white, and jaggery. Have you ever heard of a dam made like this? And say, you know, sir, what is the capacity? 11.27 TMC, sir. Can you imagine the capacity, the holding capacity of that dam? Sir, that dam, Supreme Court says, is safe. Sir, I have no complaints. You have won. We have lost. Kerala lost. Sir, in 2014 again, Supreme Court says, sir, this dam is safe. Sir, we have lost again. You won. Tamil Nadu wins. Sir, you win. Sir, my appeal to the Honorable Minister of Government is, please, sir, if this dam breaks, 5 districts of Kerala will get completely washed out. 3.5 million people will die. This will be the biggest tragedy in the history of the world. Not Hiroshima. At Hiroshima nuclear bombing, 1,47,000 people died. At Nagasaki, sir, 70,000 people died. 73,000 people died. Sir, if this dam breaks, and mind you, sir, this lease is for 999 years, and there is no clause which says that this dam needs to be rebuilt. This is the argument of some people. We have built a dam, but
please,
no,
please,
there is,
please,
sir, I agree, there is no clause for reconstruction of the dam, sir. Human life has an expectancy. Sir, human life has an expectancy. India,
please,
the life.
Please, you are not allowed.
John, please.
You are not allowed.
John, please. You are spoiling our God. Please sit down.
Please.
You are eating into my time. You are not allowing me to speak on behalf of the people of Kerala. Sir, there is a life expectancy for everything. Sir, we don't live to be 200 years. Sir, I think the life expectancy in Kerala is about in India is about 65 years. In South India, Kerala, possibly it's about 75 years. Sir, everything man-made has a life. Sir, how can a Surki dam survive? 125 years, sir, it is survived. Sir, the entire people of Kerala, 35 million people, they go to sleep every day, sir, with these nightmares, sir, they don't sleep. Because 3.5 million people would die. I appeal to my fellow brethren in this honorable house, sir, please go back to your people. Please go back to your assembly. Please go back to your government, please. All the water, sir, from that dam, we will build a new dam. I discussed with the Chief Minister. Sir, we will build a new dam just about 1,300 meters down line. Sir, you take all the water you want. Produce all the electricity you want. You want to come and fish there. Please come and catch fish. Take everything you want, sir. But please, sir, let Keralites sleep peacefully, sir. Please, my appeal to you. Sir, in 1999, that's the year when I got into IAS, and I was subcollector of this area where the Mudapariya Dam is located. Sir, on 2012-2079, the Tamil Nadu officials and the Kerala officials met. I'm placing it on the table of the House. A decision was taken to construct a new dam, and the location of the dam was also decided, sir. A lifetime, nothing happens. Here I'm placing on the table. So here is the discussion. Minutes of the meeting of the Central Water Commission where all the state government representatives are present. This is dated 29th of April 1980. Sir, 42 years. Sir, it is decided in the long term that a dam is necessary. Here, sir, I'm placing it on the table, both these records. Please, sir, save us. Honorable Minister, you are an extremely capable person. Please take it up as a central issue. It's not a question of life of a few Keralites or a few Balus out there. Sir, please take it up. Please take it to the Prime Minister. Please take it to the country. India is one. Sir, we are one. We are all one. We all come from different places. I was conceived. I was conceived in Maharashtra, delivered in Kerala, studied in Kerala, studied in Shillong. I got into the IAS, Kerala Cadre, worked as Commissioner DDA, became an MLA in Kerala. Now I am an MP from Rajasthan, sir. We all belong to this country. This country is ours. India first, sir. Sir, India first. We need to protect every life. And we have failed. Sorry, sir, we Kerala, we have failed. We people have failed. Sorry, I'm using a very unparliamentary word, sir. In Kerala,
please.
Sir, in Kerala, we don't touch anybody's feet because it is not our practice. I respect greatly the practice of North Indians when they go and touch feet. I think it's a great practice. I'm willing to go and touch the feet of everybody in this house. And to Tamil Nadu say, please, let us leave. Please. And I support this bill hugely. And Honorable Minister, please take up our case.
Thank you.